What's up? I'm Sammy Lemon. Welcome to the final episode of the Making of Awesome God VIP. And as of today, it is Friday. Means we got 2 days left to drop this song. Thought I'd get the final recording in. Hopefully the video can be posted soon in time for the release on Sunday morning. Just in time for the festivities of celebrating of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. So let's get this kicked off. First off, I was hoping to just get the drop out of the way today, but looks like we might have to patch up some other stuff. It depends. So yeah, all that stuff to do in the past two episodes is, we've made everything else in the past two episodes, except for the second drop, the final drop. What I was hoping to do is have it be some kind of melodic crap with some dubstep growls, heavy dubstep growls. May need to borrow some ideas from Cymatics once again. So yeah. What we could start doing is just working with the drop right now. So here we have the drop from 1 minute 20 seconds to 1 minute 44 seconds. It's a 25 second drop. It's pretty standard as a 16 measure drop. So let's just listen to it, because we're going to be copying and pasting most of it over into our second drop, like the drum loops, the melody line, that kind of stuff. Okay, so one thing I noticed is that we're gonna need some effects here, so I can't forget that. After drop one, let's see what we have. Oops, here we go. We have this Just Slowly preset that does that Martin Garrix, Alan Walker effect that I found that I love. Okay, so what we could do is, if we're gonna add dubstep growls, let's find some cool ones. First, let's get our drum loop pasted in here. And we're gonna have some alternation in that, so don't be surprised if you see some alternation there. Okay. Get the melody line in here, and then probably what I'll end up doing is keeping the melody line, because there's two parts of the melody line. Wrong place to paste. Then just cutting out the melody line and inserting some wobbles where the wobbles and growls where the melody line is supposed to go. Like, I could just erase the... I could erase these two notes. Then we can have some crazy growl type stuff going around, like, blah, 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 blah. Okay. I know. The sounds that are coming out of my mouth are kind of atrocious. Kind of cringy. Then we can delete this, these next couple notes here. So basically, anywhere, I'm gonna play the melody line here, and anywhere that you don't hear melody is where these growls are gonna go. Okay, so now we can just drop in some serums. Drop in some mysterious serums. I don't even know what I'm gonna do. I'm coming at this completely blank. I don't know what kind of growls I want, what kind of wobbles I want. We might get some ideas from Cymatics. We might end up using those Cymatics presets and be a junkie. Or we could just use something simple like the low filter on some weird growl table, and maybe it'll sound great. Let's grab the outbreak wave tables first. No, or the growl tables. You know, we have more than a couple. Let's just, okay. Let's just clone this a couple times. Cool. Now we have three serums waiting at our disposal. Open up the GUI and we can get to work. First one I want is probably a growl table. So let's find a growl table. Now this one's called U-Haul. My bro used a U-Haul when he moved to Texas, where DJ is. Out where DJ is, yeah, it's right by Dallas, so yeah. Down a little farther. Up a little farther. Slow it down. I don't know. Let's try band minusing and plusing this thing. Basically, band minus and band plus. Okay, so while I have our LFO1 set to move across the wavetable, so it's going back and forth, band minus and band plus doesn't just play the wavetable back and forth. It can stretch and pull it out. Like, here's what it looks like without band minus, band plus. Put the LFO into band plus. And you can stretch this thing and distort it like that. And look, I think it looks cool. Let's see how it sounds, though. I don't mind that. That's pretty cool. It's mildly adequate. Okay, so we can do that, but we're gonna need to have some external effects and LFOs on it. I don't know exactly how I'm gonna go about doing this, so we can... Let's first grab a filter. We can try out our own, making our own stuff. And if that don't work, none, and I'm not satisfied with that. Then let's go directly to Cymatics and let them do some work for us. Because we're lazy boats. I don't even know why I said that. Filter action. How about that? Getting quite silent. Let's get a flanger. Turn up the volume. Sync at BPM. Thank you. I don't. That's kind of cool. I like that. What's it at? 1/4? 1/8? Let's make it 1/2. Okay, so we got some cool stuff there. Let's grab a hyper slash dimension. That's pretty cool. Let's try linking the mix. Link the mix to the dimension too. Add a phaser so I can so it can sound a little bit like snails. That's pretty cool. Turn up the rate a little more. Kind of doing the same thing that the flanger's doing. Depth up to probably around 80%. We have a lot of side action, so it's really going to fill out the headphones there. Turn the stereo up more. I'm going to turn it down, see what we have that. I like that one. Okay. What we can do is we can take the mix and just have it go. I like that. I like that. We can put a compressor below all that. Multi-band compressor, OTT type stuff. Yeah, CM comes built in with OTT, which is fun to know. Increase the gain a bit. Increase the attack and the ratios. But decrease the threshold. Turn down the mix. That's got some cool stuff going on. Let's link the release on here. No, not the release. I'm sorry. Bad idea. Okay, the attack and the threshold. That's pretty cool. The ratio, did I say threshold or threshold or ratio or threshold combination? I don't understand anymore. That's kind of cool. Has a lot of movement on it. Okay. We can get an EQ. Yeah, make sure that it's cut off our low end. Alright, make it go fast now. Sounds like some crazy, almost sounds like it's a guitar. I mean, I was listening to that one remix of, Why? There's no reason. Stupid band again. I was listening to the remix of Tell Me. You know, What's So Not? They just, What's So Not worked with RL Grime and Skrillex on the, song, Waiting, but I looked into RL Grime stuff and What's So Not stuff. I looked into Rut's Not stuff because I'm like, wow, I mean, he did really good with the trumpets on Waiting, so let's see how his stuff is. I mean, he has a song called Jaguar that sounds really cool, but he also had this song called Tell Me, which was remixed by a guy called Rude Brat, I think. And so, he made a remix of it. The beginning was standard trap EDM, just like this song. But when he got to the drop, he changed up the style like that, and it went from trap to heavy metal. So, and all you heavy metal fans out there, go to like Tell Me, Rude Rat Remix, and just feel that, because he uses like heavy metal, but I think he has a growl that uses a lot of phaser action below that heavy metal, or he just kept the heavy metal and used phaser action on his guitar. So that's what I was that's what made me think about that. Mess with the cue here. There's some like little foley in the background I can use. I'll have to remember then. Okay, let's get a filter doing something different. A flange filter. Flange. H6 plus. We'll have cutoff moving. That does sound kind of snailsy, if snails were to go harder growl. Add a saw, but drop it down one octave. Two octaves? Turn the level down. Turn it down to zero. But link LFO1 to it, so the volume goes up as the LFO is progressing. I can take that. Not bad. Not bad. We might look to get some. I see. I can do growls, okay, but I still need help with the metallic bass. That I'm still trying to sort through those presets that I got and learn how to really make metallic bass better. I use more of the growls in my most recent productions. But yeah. So let's since I made this preset myself, I'm gonna save it down. What should we call it? Let's call it Phaser Flanger Madness. If you guys want these presets, I might actually make a pack that you guys can take. It'll be free because I love you guys, and I wouldn't make you pay money. No, you'd have to follow me and have to look at all my posts. Ha! Even worse. Okay, so beat drops, and then that growl's gonna go here. So let's put that there. Left the filter side up, so now it's gonna glitch out. Let's give it mono voicing. Make it legato. Put the portamento up so we have a nice slide. Okay, now metallic growls. Those can usually be found in the your outbake outbake yes outbreak wavetables, like square ones. Wee wee. That's more of a sign. I don't know. See, it starts out as a simple sign, and then gets hairy. As far as I can tell, that's what it does. So, let's link Alpha-1 to it. Be cool for some, like, hybrid trap. That's gonna have a lot of, sign on it, so means we won't need to provide a sub. Let's find some other stuff, though. They gave me an organ. Wow. Paid $100 for that. I love it. That's some cool pad stuff. I mean, not all of these are growl tables, so I might have to look through them some more. That's got more of a A lot of these do have like sine. See, look, they're in the shape of sine waves. That's got a weird, that's a prevalent talking sound. It's cool. Modern talking kind of stuff. Robots. Monstrous. Okay, let's do that. Just on oscillator B. So we have just the filter going on oscillator B. Take the cutoff. Turn it off even more. Beef out these sides. Like that. Don't tell me that this thing's detuned, please. Yeah, this is I'm just trying to find some just trying to find some metallic stuff. Let's see. Well, we might have to go through the presets and get some ideas. So, yay. Alright, let's first go to the Outbreak presets. Face slap. With the filter. Okay. Keep going. Death in the swamps. Yeah, there you go. Wow. Sorry if I seem like really tired this time. It's because I just finished up my run for today, and I'm all tired. Most of these are like just instant wobs instead of like in a hybrid trap you get like whole loops almost like that. I think I just used the OTT reverb. And then use the macro number one. Yeah, basically I'm just exploring the presets here, so I should probably get a move on. Death sentence. Okay, let's find a metallic bass real quick, and we can get this over with. The Beast. Which one's linked to, there. And we gotta find one here. Smoothie. I don't even. All of these have a lot of sub behind them. There's some scream for us. I don't know about this. Let's try, okay, so, if we can use these two, the same presets that we used in our last mix, as I mean the original. Let's use some of the samples there. The Borgore like loops I had labeled that I got. That's not one of them. Nope. Sorry. Nope. There it is. Alright, so we can mess around with that growl for a little bit. Yeah, that sounds absolutely weird. Let's keep that how that is. Yeah, so that's how it comes back and right in up to that measure. So that needs to be mono, doesn't it? I thought I said it there first time. Turn up that portamento. Sounds really weird. And when does this come back in here? Comes in, okay, a little bit after the first. I don't know if that's actually on beat there for a minute. I have to check. BPM, let's see, BPM. Here, let's make it symmetrical. We can mess with the chords here in a second. I gotta get these growls out of the way. Let's make that twice as long while cutting off one of these notes. That way, it can match up with the chord progression a little better. I don't understand why this isn't sounding like it's linking with the BPM. There you go, I had to select the trigger. Okay. That should fix it. Okay, now, well, another question, the big question is, will the sub fit? I don't understand why it's sounding so loud, but with anything else, it's sounding really soft. Is that the same? Yep, it's the same loop. Okay, now. There's our bass. Oops. Whoopsie. All right. So we can get. It's right here. That's better. Okay, now I gotta get that last growl, or maybe a scream, right here. Can we use this one? What's up with you? Turn off the sub. Faster. Make it faster! Is that pleasant or not? You want to use that same growl that we use the right before the who? You know, I actually didn't. Usually when I, before I start recording, shut up, I will usually, oh goodness. I'll usually just, open up both projects, but I didn't open up one this time. So, I only opened up the newest one, but I didn't open up, when I opened up my Awesome God projects, I didn't open up my original project. I opened up the first one, the one that we were working on, but not this one. This is the original project, so, I'm thinking about using... Thinking about using here. Right here. Okay, it's a start, it's a part of that restart loop that I used from Tosoki in the Kinphonic Record free sample pack. So let's grab that. I know it's a sample, and I'm a preset junkie, but the samples, de muy bueno, they're really good, so I liked using them, and I guess it would harken back to my original track more, which when you do a VIP, you gotta use the same, gotta use some of the same samples in the original track, like, if you guys remember Africa by Dion Timmer Next Shizun, they did a VIP of that song, And they did not use hardly any of their original samples. They just like I don't even know if they had the original vocals from the song in it. So, you know, that's something you gotta do when you do a VIP is have some original stuff in it. Should be here. I just gotta find it. Should be right there. There we go. Then we clone that, but play the clone in reverse. Okay, so how that, see how that goes. Take that part out. Okay, so we have the project saved. And surprise people, but we might actually use that who that we did in the original remix. Let's grab that and see how it sounds. You know, if this video and does end up getting posted before the actual release, I'm gonna be checking the comments to make sure that everyone's like, no, it's a terrible idea, don't do it, because if this ends up sounding terrible, I can then we can change it because you know it's pre-release. Get a little reverb there. Give it the tail and the bandwidth. We don't need to blend as much. monkeys. Sounds like monkeys. Okay. See how that sounds. Take it from the top. Okay, now, on this Garfunkel thing sounds really loud, so I'm going to change that to, I am not feeling this growl thing we just made. I'm sure I'll find a use for it somewhere, but, you know, you have to be flexible in making these mixes, so I think we might have to forgo it. Unfortunately, we have some of these, we have some other stuff we can use to replace it, so we'll keep it on hand. We won't delete it from the project, but we'll just delete the part that it's in. Also, I will clone these Borgore-like loops things, but find something else for it. I want it to be, sound similar. How does it sound right here? It's almost barely noticeable here, but there it sounds right. Okay, so what we can do is probably clone it, or just not use it at all at the very end. Let's just not use it at all, because, yeah. Octaves, because octaves are cool. Okay, and we gotta change up this piano here. So I took off the end there. And so let's see how that sounds. Start low, then go high. We can leave it at that. Okay, after the ending. Now back to our drop. We have to paste in these chords. Did I leave this part up? No. No. Okay. So basically, I keep saying basically just because it's basically basic to say basically. We gotta find, gotta find a way to keep these out of here, but at the same time be able to use their LFOs. Well, they're just repeated, so. So again, just take them down to that 1/4 mark. Instead of having it drop right out there, what we can do is at the very beginning. We can move this part. Yeah, right there. Try that. Yeah, that'll work. Here, how about... Here, yeah, put that up there. Okay. Okay, so we gotta find more, Wait a minute. What if we just put that there? What if we move the growls and the who? Yeah, that even fits, doesn't it? Alright, try again. Oops. Sorry. When you save a large project with lots of serums and LMS, it tends to glitch out. But it didn't crash, which I'm thankful for. Okay, now. Right here. Oops. Now. See how those plucks sound over here, because I... Maybe it's my headphones. I might have blown them out or something, but, kicks here are sounding kind of quiet. Let's see if that's the case here. It can sound good there. What about here? Yeah, they sound okay here. Okay. What we gotta do now? Is make sure that there ain't nothing more we can grab from original. That's also from Playtime is Over. The soapy presets is what I meant. I know I use that a lot. That I could use. Let's go to the heavy stuff. Hey, what's that? The 8th loop. We can use that. You're all preset junkies. Alright, so I think that's all we're gonna get out of the original. So, make one more change, and then we'll get to mixing. Oh, then we'll get to mixing them all down and mastering. We can make sure this project is moi. To tell you the truth, I don't really know too much about mastering, I just... Let's use that, Okay. Trim that up. We'll be right back. single hit there, replacing the rest of that growl. And we'll put it. How much of a break is that up here? Okay, just first verse 3. Oops, I cut out the wrong one. Whoops. Okay, and then to cut down, get out this part. Okay, for the save. All right. Let's play through the song. And give it a listen, make sure that there's no effects that we can't add. And if there are, then, you know, we'll add some effects. If not, we can export this track. All right.
Yeah.
I need to add an effect, like, okay, we can add a reverse of that. What's our impact? Let's clone that. Clear the track, but play it in reverse. Okay, so see how long that takes. Let's boost the volume on that. There's only minor effects, but seeing past that, effects 19. Let's clone that. Effects 19 is a good one to do backwards, or to play in reverse. Cool. And for being 6 seconds long. I'd say that's about 2 measures. That'll work. Okay. I think that who thing needs to leave. I think that's what it needs to do. I don't think that. Here, just listen. I think that if we could cut it, I mean, I just love that. It's a perfect, perfect add-in. Oh gosh, it's a little high. Here, try that. Okay, and also, we'll be right back. Let's try it in the other one though, in the beginning. I think that works better. That right here. That part right there, that's kind of needed for this melody line to go forward. And the way that that vocal is placed kind of cuts out that part. I love using that pattern of vocal with that growl because it's such a good idea. It harks back to the original, but it cuts out that melody line, so I don't think we'll be able to use that as I intended. So I think we might have to say goodbye to the guys going who like owls. So, I think we might have to cut that vocal out because it's just affecting this melody line way too much. Yeah. So let's work on. Now. There you go, I got confused there for a moment. That white noise sweep. The white noise should be right here. Almost. Oops. Actually, on second thought, the white noise sweep was played just after this measure, so let's put in the other one. I'm gonna save that down. Bay City. How about just bass like pluck? Bass like pluck. Wow. So Seems that this thing has some pitch shift in it somewhere. It's probably because of this Dyson thing right here. This loop envelope to it. It sounds detuned though. It's because of this table. Let's try the trilobites. Those never disappoint. That gives some more pluck experience because you have it going from metallic to non-metallic, I guess. So let's see how it works down here. Thumbs up. We're keeping it like that. So, okay, I think we should export this, and we should post it day after tomorrow, because this track is done, as far as I'm concerned. I'm going to export it, run it through Audacity, and see how well, Awsign. Wow, awesome, god, VIP. Alright. Start the exporting. So let's run it through Audacity and make sure that the end silence is at the right amount and the beginning silence is at the right amount. And we have enough effects there. Make sure it's not, we didn't export it too loud. And put it through the final thing. Dang, I can't wait. Can't wait for release, guys. I know I got a lot of positive feedback about it coming out soon, and there a lot of other people can't wait for release too. So I'm really glad you guys are all hyped. I'm glad that we can get this song out there for all. It's gonna be free download, obviously. So we should be able to just see, it's almost done. Yeah, spring break has been very busy, but it's been fun, and I've had some time to work on some, to work on a lot of my other projects. I added a song to, the Fight the Darkness EP, so let's export the track. Just drop it on my desktop. There it is, on my desktop. Open up Audacity. Strangers and Pilgrims on the Earth. Hebrews 11:13. Yeah, I got this app that plays a Bible verse every 30 seconds, but sometimes it'll just, I feel like it's just plucking random phrases out of the Bible. Strangers and Pilgrims on the Earth. Lord is thy God, in the midst of thee is mighty. He will save. That's a good one. Keep it. Please, Audacity, open up. I told you to open up. There you go. Import audio off of my desktop. Awesome God, VIP. And this is what she's gonna look like. Is this too loud? Now it's just the buildup, so we should be okay. Thank you. Linux cut off the silence. Okay, but okay. I'll fix that later, but right now let's have a listen to the whole track. And that'll be it, guys, because this thing's finished. So yeah, it was I might add more effects after this. My EQ it a bit. I'm definitely gonna EQ. But yeah, this is it. This is the product of three and a half episodes of the making of Awesome God VIP. We are done. We have made this song. So thank you so much for your input in the comments section. So glad that I could do this and record it. Yeah, I'm Sammy Lemon, and this is Awesome God VIP. Have a listen. Okay, so obviously we need some more end silence, more of this reverb here, to just keep going back to probably about 3 minutes 30 seconds. But, otherwise, the growls and the drop, and the second drop, I actually forgot to add some reverb, some white noise effects. I could probably do that in my spare time later, but until then, I hope you guys enjoyed the Easter eggs that popped up right as this mix was playing. Yes, the whatever it was Dropbox was doing over there. That is alluding to another song in Awesome God VIP. Not Awesome God VIP. Fight the Darkness EP. So, I'm gonna give you another preview of Fight the Darkness EP. I made this song over in about 2 or 3 days over spring break called Go Boom. I'm gonna skip to the drop. I don't want to spoil it too heavily. Okay, so there's a preview of that track for you. Probably what I'm going to do with Fight the Darkness is when, after I finish all the tracks, I'm going to release one or two right as we're finishing up the last couple. And as we finish, the rest of the tracks, I'm going to have two tracks out. Then we're not going to release them all at once. Because if I release them all at once, people are just going to see this massive playlist on my profile, and they're going to be like, well, I don't have to listen to all of them, do I? So if we just post them, like, one at a time over a span of, I don't know, a month and a half, it's how Getter released What the Frick EP. So that's, you, like, release the main couple songs, and then release the rest of the tracks to follow, put them all, and wrapped them up with a big bow and said, boom, EP. So yes. That's how that's gonna work. But until then, you guys can enjoy Awesome God VIP when it drops on Sunday. Yeah, this has been really fun. I am just incredibly happy that I can make this song, because Awesome God was when I sparked the Christian productions of Sammy Lemon, because before my music wasn't at all Christian. It was going to the secular realm, but making secular EDM means that you can hint towards things that usually happen on the EDM scene, you know, that aren't Christian at all. Awesome God really, I gave myself a kick in the pants and said, wow, I need to really get back and think about why music is, what the real purpose of music is, and that, like everything else in this world, is to glorify God. Music, like anything else, is to glorify God, and that's something that we all have to realize, that everything is being used for God's purpose. And until then, I'm Sammy Lemon, and you just watched me make Awesome God VIP. Thank you so much. You all like and subscribe to this wonderful channel who gives you wonderful music. Thanks so much for watching. Thanks so much for listening. I'll see y'all later. Keep calm and drop the hardest bass you can find.